So we have this triangle A, B, C. So this triangle has three sides, AB, BC and CA. Now let's find the midpoint of each of these sides. So to find the midpoint of A and B, the side AB, what I'll do is I'll overlap A to B. So if I join these two vertices, then this point gives me the midpoint of AB. This is equal to this, and hence I can say that this point is the midpoint of AB. Let me call this point as D. So let me mark this point and call it D. Now let's find midpoint of A and C. Again, if you bring C to A, join these two vertices here. So this point here, I perfectly get this overlapped. So this is equal to this, and hence I can say that this point is the midpoint of AC. Let me call this point as E. So I call this point as E. Similarly, I can find the midpoint of side BC also. So here you see that these two sides are equal in length. So this is equal to this. So this is the midpoint of BC. And let me call this point as F. So what I get is triangle ABC with three midpoints, D, E and F. So these are the three midpoints. Now if I join any of these two midpoints, what I get is a line segment which is called midsegment. So midsegment is a line that joins two midpoints, any two midpoints. So I join D and E. So I've joined D and E here. So this line DE is the midsegment. Now observe that this DE gives me another triangle. So I get this triangle. You can observe this triangle ADE. So this is one triangle. I've got another triangle and the main triangle was ABC. So what we see is that in both these triangles, A is being shared. What is changing is DE and BC. So I have 1, 2. These are the two triangles. DE and BC is changing. Let us try to see if there is any relation between DE, which is the midsegment, and BC, which is the side of the triangle. So I mark DE with color blue, which is the midsegment, and BC, which is the side of the triangle, by a color green. So now I want to find the relation between these two. Clearly you can see that these two lines are parallel. Blue is parallel to green. So I can say that these two lines are parallel. Let me denote these parallel lines by this sign. So I know that these two lines are parallel. Now, is there any relation between the length of these sides? Let me see. So let's say this is DE. So if I fold, I want to see if there is any relation between DE, this blue line, and this green line. If I fold it, then what do I find? That DE and this green line now are the same. So if I call DE as X, then till here, this green line is also X. What I need to find is X plus this line is BC. So now what is this line? If I fold this line, then I see that this line, which is this line, is actually equal to X again. This is also equal to X. So I find that BC, which is the side of the triangle, is X plus X, which is 2X, whereas DE is X. So DE is parallel to BC and DE is half of BC. This was 2x, this is x. So this is half of BC and is parallel. So we've seen that if DE was x, then BC turned out to be 2x. So DE is parallel to BC and is half of BC. This is what the midsegment theorem says. So the midsegment theorem says that the midsegment, which is the line that joins midpoints of two sides, is parallel to the third side and it is half of the third side. So here, let's say this is the midpoint of AB and this is the midpoint of AC. So I join the midpoints. So this is my midsegment. Now this midsegment is parallel to the third side BC. These two lines are parallel. Also, it is half of BC. BC is 37, half of 37, 18.5. Now what you will observe is, if I do not change BC and I move A, note that the midsegment, the length of the midsegment will not change. Even if I move A, my length of the midsegment is not changing because BC is not changing. Midsegment depends on the third side BC and it is half of BC and it is always parallel also. So even if I am changing my triangle such that BC is not moving, then this is always remaining as 18.5, half and parallel. Now as soon as I change this side BC, the midsegment will change. Let's say I make it 36. Now as soon as BC is 36, my midsegment changes to 18, half of 36, which is 18, and still it is parallel. Now it will remain 18 if I do not change BC. So the midsegment is always parallel and half of the third side. Now let us try to prove this theorem. So we say that the line segment that joins midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and is half of it also. So first let's make a triangle ABC. So this is a triangle ABC. Let's say we need to first find a line segment that joins the midpoints of two sides. Let's say the midpoint of AB is D. And let's say the midpoint of AC is E. If D is the midpoint of AB, then BD would be equal to AD. And if E is the midpoint of AC, then AE would be equal to EC. So this is what you get. D and E are the midpoints. AD is equal to DB, AE is equal to EC. What I want to prove is that the line that joins these midpoints, so the line that would join these midpoints, I want to prove that this line DE is parallel to BC and DE is parallel to BC. Also, I want to prove that DE is actually half of BC. This is what I want to prove. So this is what I want to prove. So how do I begin my proof? Let me draw a line from C which is parallel to BA. So I draw a line from C parallel to BA. So this and this is parallel. Now I produce this line DE such that it meets this parallel line at point F. Now let us look at these two triangles, ADE and CFE. Let's look at these two triangles. So in these two triangles, what we see is AE is equal to EC. So I know that AE is equal to EC because E was the midpoint of AC, so AE is equal to EC. Now the second thing is, I know that AC and DF are, these two lines are intersecting at point E. So I have these two angles which are getting formed. Let's call this 1 and 2. So 1 is equal to 2 because they are vertically opposite angles. Now let us look at these two parallel lines, BA and CF. So AC is actually forming a transversal in these two parallel lines. So you can see a Z here. And so I can say that this angle, let's call this 3, would be equal to this angle, let's call this 4. Why? Because these are interior alternate angles. So I can say that angle 3 is equal to angle 4, interior alternate angles. So I have three pairs here. AE equals to EC, one side, 1 equals to 2 angle, and 3 is equal to 4. So I have two angles and one side. So angle, side, angle, again angle, side, and angle. So by angle, side, angle, I can say that these two triangles are congruent. Once I know that two triangles are congruent, then the corresponding parts of these two congruent triangles will also be equal. So I can say that DE would be equal to FE. If DE would be equal to FE, then that means that E is the midpoint of DF. Also, from here, I can say that AD would be equal to CF. Both of these I can say by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So I can say that AD would be equal to CF and DE is equal to EF. So E becomes the midpoint. So from CPCT I know that AD is equal to CF and DE is equal to EF. Now AD is equal to CF, agreed. But AD is also equal to DB because D is the midpoint of AB. Since D is the midpoint of AB, AD would be equal to BD. Now I have AD which is equal to CF. AD is also equal to BD. So I can say that these two would also be equal. That is, CF should be equal to BD. So I get CF should be equal to BD. So CF and BD would be equal. So BD is equal to CF. I see that BD is equal to CF. Now in DBCF, you will see that DB is equal to CF and DB is also parallel to CF. So I have these two sides, opposite sides equal, and these opposite sides are parallel also. Since opposite sides are parallel and equal, I can say that DBCF is a parallelogram. So I can say that DBCF is a parallelogram. If it's a parallelogram, then the pair of opposite sides are parallel and equal also. So if this is parallel to this and this is equal to this, I can also say that DF would be parallel to BC. The other pair of sides would also be parallel and DF would be equal to BC also. So these two sides would be parallel and equal. So I get DF parallel to BC and DF is equal to BC also. Now what I wanted to prove was that DE is parallel to BC, but I have got DF parallel to BC. Now DE produced is DF, so DE is also parallel to BC. So I can say that DE is parallel to BC and this side DF is equal to BC. So now one part is done. So I have proved this. This is done. What I need to show is that DE is half of BC. We know that DE is equal to EF. Since DE is equal to EF, DE is half of DF. I can say that DE is half of DF. But now we know that DF is equal to BC. We know DF is equal to BC. So rather than writing DF, I can write BC here. So I can say that DE would be half of BC. So DE is half of BC. This is what I wanted to prove, that DE is parallel to BC, which I have proved here. Second was that DE is half of BC, which I have proved here. So these are the two things that I wanted to prove. DE parallel to BC and DE half of BC. So we've seen that midsegment is parallel to the third side and it is half of the third side also. Now let's try to see where we can apply this. So an architect wanted to make this triangular window with glass in the lower half and bamboo sticks in the upper half. Now, what would be the length of the bamboo sticks that he would need, the maximum length that he would need? We know that the bamboo sticks are being placed in the upper half. So this would be the midpoint. So if this is triangle ABC, let's say this is triangle ABC, and let's call D and E as midpoints of AB and AC respectively. So now DE is the midsegment. As I move away from the midsegment towards the vertex, what I see is that the length of the length of the bamboo sticks is decreasing. Again, if I move from the midsegment towards the base, then the length is increasing. But in the lower half, we do not need bamboo sticks. We need bamboo sticks only in the upper half. So this DE is the maximum that the bamboo length is the maximum length of bamboo stick that we would need. And DE is a line that joins the midpoints, hence it's a midsegment. We know that midsegment is always half of the third side and is parallel to the third side also. So since DE would be half of BC, the third side, I can say that DE would be half of BC is 12. This gives me that DE would be 6 meters. So the maximum length of bamboo sticks that you would need is 6 meters.